Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station update. On board the station is the crew of Expedition 32, currently commanded by Russian cosmonaut CENNADY PADALKA there in the center. To the left is another Russian cosmonaut, Sergei Revin, on his first space flight. And on the right there, NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, veteran of one shuttle mission STS-119, on his first long-duration stay on board the International Space Station. So the crew pretty busy this week, doing a range of science experiments and maintenance work to systems on board the International Space Station. Starting off on Monday, Commander PADALKA was doing some maintenance on the Russian comm system. He was working alongside Sergei Revin as they looked to do an upgrade to the integrated command and telemetry system, which is functions on the S-band communication, and it'll be used for future payload transmissions to ground sites, as these astronauts are always working in conjunction with subject matter experts on the ground for any payloads and experiments. And aside from that, PADALKA was also working on cleaning some of the dust filters in the Mini Research Module 1 or the Rosviet module, making sure that the astronauts' air revitalization systems are working in tip-top shape. Meanwhile, Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin was stowing some items inside of the 47 Progress vehicle, that Russian unmanned cargo craft currently docked to the International Space Station. It'll have some pretty interesting activities a little bit later this month as it undocks on July 22nd and redocks just a little over a day later, testing out one of its new CORS automatic rendezvous system, which always guides these unmanned cargo craft to the International Space Station. After that redocking test, it'll undock for the final time on July 30th, and then re-enter and burn up in the Earth's atmosphere. And meanwhile, on Monday, NASA astronaut Joe Acaba was working with the BCAT-6 experiment, BCAT standing for the Binary Colloidal Alloy Test. Colloids are these tiny suspensions of particles and fluids, and is one of the many particle experiments on board the station, giving researchers here on the ground some fundamental insights into the base level of how particles grow and crystallize in microgravity. He was mixing, photographing, and stowing some of those samples. And also on Monday, he did his first work with the station's Earth Cam, which stands for Earth Knowledge Acquired by Middle School Students. And he was setting that up inside of the Window Observational Research Facility on board the station. This was in preparation for some week-long activities that have been going on, where over 120 different schools and groups across the country have been controlling that camera via controls on the internet, allowing students, again, across the country a chance to use the station's unique vantage point to take photos of different geological features around the globe. Moving on to Tuesday, Commander PADALKA was inside of another unmanned cargo craft, the ATV-3, doing a assembly, removal, and replacement work on the cabin fan. This was done in preparation for some cargo activities later on in the week. So all of this was necessary to make the ATV-3 vehicle, which you can see here on your screen. It's the largest unmanned resupply vehicle that visits the International Space Station. And he was doing that cabin fan assembly replacement work in preparation for some cargo work he'd be doing later in the week. He was also busy inspecting and photographing some of the windows on the station's service module on the Russian segment, looking for any discoloration or any potential nicks or scratches. You can see the station layout here, that ATV-3 docked to the aft portion of the station, the Progress 47 craft docked to the nadir or the Earth-facing side, and their Soyuz TMA-04M spacecraft docked to the Poisk module on the zenith or space-facing side. It's the craft that brought these astronauts to the International Space Station just back in May. Also on Tuesday, Sergei Revin was stowing some more items inside of that 47 Progress craft and doing an update to the station's inventory management system, which looks to track all the items on board the station. And Joe Acaba was back doing a few checkouts on that Earth cam and also troubleshooting the station's ISSS camera, which is another Earth observations project on board the station, which ISSS stands for International Space Station Agricultural Camera. He was troubleshooting a laptop failure that's used to control it. And once he was done with all that, he took some time out of his day to do a ham radio contact with the WISH program here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, that was women in STEM high school aerospace scholars, using the station's ham radio to do a quick Q&A with students down here on the ground. Moving on to Wednesday, Gennady Padalka woke up and immediately went into sample collection for the Russian immuno experiment, taking blood, saliva, and urine samples, which is then used to check for different hormones associated with stress response. This immuno study looks to track any changes in the astronauts' immune system during their long duration space flights, and also couples it with stress tests to find any correlations between an increase or decrease of stress and functioning of the human body's immune system. He was also doing some more window inspections in the service module, also known as VESDA, and doing some repair and recovery work on the Russian Vozduk system, which is one of the air revitalization systems on board the station, which looks to constantly scrub carbon dioxide from the breathing atmosphere for these astronauts, and also working on the station's atmospheric system with Sergei Revin, who's doing some maintenance on the Russian Electron, which is their oxygen generation system. There are quite a few over on the U.S. segment as well, but these Russians were doing some routine maintenance, getting theirs up and working. And Revin was also cleaning a few of the ventilation screens on the Zarya module's interior panels and also working on its gas-liquid heat exchanger. Meanwhile, on Wednesday, Joe Acaba was doing his first checkout of the HTV hardware command panel. That HTV vehicle is scheduled to launch next week on July 21st, and then rendezvous and capture and berth just about 6 days later. That is an unmanned cargo craft from the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, which will be delivering for about 4.6 tons of cargo to this newly expanded Expedition 32 crew. Acaba was also at work with the Sphere satellites, doing a few test runs as they practice their automated rendezvous and docking procedures. Sphere is standing for the Synchronized Position Hold, Engage, and Reorient Experimental Satellites. These small bowling ball sized objects, you can see the orange one there spinning in the middle of your screen, completely autonomous and self-contained satellites that practice things like formation flying and docking using algorithms that are written down and uplinked from the ground. So moving on to Thursday, Commander Padalka was back inside of that ATV cargo craft, moving a few trash items in as they looked to clear up space for cargo coming up on that HTV vehicle. He was also doing some monthly maintenance on the station's TVIS, which is the treadmill with vibration and isolation stabilization. And that was just some monthly maintenance to make sure it's still working as it should be. And then Sergei Revin was busy taking his own saliva and blood samples for that Russian immuno test, and also did some hardware setup and execution of the Russian relaxation experiment, which looks to determine the effects of propulsion system exhaust on the Earth's upper atmosphere, and also on any optically sensitive surfaces on board the station, like windows, equipment, lenses, and solar array panels. And meanwhile, on Thursday, Joe Acaba was hard at work on that BAS experiment, BAS standing for the Burning and Suppression of Solids. He uses a fuel system and an igniter and then a series of fans to combust a bunch of different solid fuel samples and then study their burn characteristics and the best way in which to suppress them, and an ongoing study to figure out the best way to combat any potential accidental fires that might break out in microgravity. And all that brings us to today, Friday, where starting off with Russian Commander Gennady Padalka, who immediately upon waking up participated in the Russian Sprut experiment alongside with Sergei Revin, that looks to study the distribution of fluids and microgravity throughout these astronauts' bodies, as gravity is not constantly pushing everything down towards your legs. It kind of redistributes and can have effects on how well these astronauts stay hydrated. It's a Russian study looking to combat any of the negative effects that may come out of that. And Padalka will also be doing a test a little bit later today on the station's TV system through their KU band, which delivers all the video from the station down to the ground. And that's all being done in preparation for the upcoming monitoring of their Soyuz docking, which will be delivering their three new crew members next week on Tuesday at about 11:52 p.m. Central Time. And aside from that Sprut experiment, his fellow Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin is doing some inspection of a few more windows inside of the station's service module, or his VESDA, again looking for any discoloration or potential dings or scratches on the inside or outside. And Joe Acaba, meanwhile, is closing out his week, cleaning a few more exhaust and intake ducts inside of the crew quarters, and then opening up the U.S. lab's window shutters in support of that Isaac camera, the International Space Station Agricultural Camera, which he was troubleshooting a little bit earlier this week, and doing a final swap out on some of those EarthCam batteries as students continue to control that camera via the internet to take pictures of geological features around the planet.